Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Short Stories of Imam Hasan Ali Shah. In 1843, Imam Hasan Ali Shah built his residence called Mahalat in Jerak, Sindh. On those days, many Ismailis from different parts of India came in Jerak for the Didar. Some Ismailis from Gujarat with their families also came. One person among them presented two sealed boxes as a nazarana and implored, "Maula, I have brought exclusively special gift for your retinue, containing pure ghee made of my own buffalo's milk." The Imam laughed and said, "You have brought kerosene, not ghee. Well, it will be useful for lighting the lamps." The person was surprised, and when the boxes were opened, kerosene was found therein. Then another person presented a nazrana of a box and said, "Maula, I have brought pure sweet oil for you." The Imam smiled and said, "You have brought Peshawari honey, not oil." It was also opened, in which was found the Peshawari honey. The Imam said, "Well, I accept choice of your wife." The person was greatly surprised. The Imam cast mercy upon the person whose boxes contained kerosene instead of ghee and said, "Don't be afraid. Actually, your boxes have been changed, which we will receive just now." Meanwhile, one camel man came with two boxes and told, "In unholding the goods, your boxes were wrongly given to another person, who returned me, and his boxes are with you. Please take it and return my boxes. These boxes contained pure ghee." Later, it was also known about another person that when he put sweet oil in the box in his house in Gujarat, his wife, being a faithful, thought that presenting oil to the Imam was inappropriate, and she secretly replaced the box of oil and put Peshawari honey in the box. Story 2. The Akhund's family was an origin of Jharak, who migrated from Kutch. They transcribed old copies of the Ginans and distributed in plausible rate. The best known among them was Akhund Ghulam. Once the Ismailis of the Sindh went to have the Didar of Imam Hasan Ali Shah in Bombay, the Imam told them that when they return to Sindh, they must go to Jharak and tell Akhund that, "You are weeping and longing in love for me, which is needless, because I am happy with you." The Imam also said, "Verily, the fire of hell is unlawful for you. You are mine and I am thine." When the Ismailis came in Jharak and submitted Imam's message, he began to weep profusely. Looking at it, the Ismailis also wept and told him, "You must be mirthful that the Lord is delightful with you." He said, "Imam is a carefree king. Today he is joyous with me, who has seen the next day. Who can claim that how the last breath will pass? Many persons remain faithful in the world, but waste their faith at last moment of their lives. Likewise, I cannot claim whether the mercy of the Imam will last with me till my last breath. Certainly, the abiding faith, Iman, and the fidelity of Akhund burned with steady flame in his heart till his last breath."